I was talking with Terry, actually, recently about kind of the stories people tell on stage and how sometimes they stop being funny after a while. And he just walked in, so I guess now we have to decide. Terry, is my Bruce Springsteen story still funny or not? That was a terrible way to ask him. I'm sorry, friend. But only slightly, because now I can tell it. So about 2 years ago, I met Bruce Springsteen. Yeah. He was doing that book signing there at Book People, and it was about this time of year. It was actually like a week ago today. Almost, because it was the 1st of December. So it was about the temperature it is now, currently. And you may have noticed I'm not the most succinct when I speak. And I knew I was going to be nervous, like really, really, really nervous, because it's Bruce Springsteen. You have 6 seconds when you're at one of those book signings that get you in and out quickly, because he's got to meet like 500 people that day, and then go meet another 500 people the next day. And he's Bruce Springsteen, he doesn't have time for that. But he made time. And so my plan was to get there super, super early, 6:30, and be first in line. I was 8th. In the morning, it was dark. And you had to stay in line. You couldn't, like, leave the line and come back. I thought we were going to get wristbands that were numbered. Mm-mm. They were like, no, you got to stay here. I'm like, cool. Because the other part of the story is that my idea of making an impression after knowing that I couldn't succinctly say all of the things I wanted to say to him in 6 seconds was I was just going to wear something really cool and make an impression that way. So I found this gold sequin dress at Kerrville, of all places, the Kerrville Folk Festival. And remember, it's December. It's 6:30 in the morning, and they're not going to let us in until like 11 o'clock in the morning. So we're sitting out there, and the news cameras come by, and they're, you know, covering the story, but they're like, you're in a gold sequin mini dress, so we're going to talk to you. But I hadn't had a full dose of coffee, because a full dose of coffee is like a 32-ounce Yeti, and I didn't want that to have to happen, and I also didn't want to be, like, so caffeinated that I was just a blur of gold sequins. And so the news interview was kind of terrifying and awful, but it's like the worst. My mom came to a show about 6 months ago, and she's like, we were driving home after, and she's like, can I say something? I was like, okay, well, sure, you can tell me anything, I guess, what's going on? And she's... Maybe when you're on stage, you don't say, and so much. Thanks, Mom. Super conscious of it every single show now. Anyway, back to the Bruce Springsteen story. So we're in line, and we're like, finally they let us in. And we start creeping up the staircase, and there's three flights of book people, if you don't know that, if you're from not out of town. He's up on the very top level, and they've got him like barricaded, and that we get all the way up there. And they're still like, you gotta wait longer. So we wait and wait and wait. And we're telling dirty Santa jokes, and it's getting weird real fast. And we've been in line with each other now for like 5.5 hours. So we're all buddies, and it's just weird. And finally let us in. And there's all the photographers, and then they're like taking people's phones so they can take their picture with Bruce and doing the whole thing. And he really liked the dress, so it was fine. Yes, it was an incredibly happy, excited ending. And then we went to Kirby Lane and had pancakes. Yes. Yes, I was that girl at like noon in Kirby Lane in a gold sequin mini dress. Completely stone cold sober. Well, it's Saturday night, you're all dressed up in blue, and I've been watching you a while, and maybe you've been watching me too. So somebody ran out, left someone's heart in a maze, and if you're looking for love, honey, I'm tougher than the rest.
Some girls they want a handsome dame or some good looking Joe. And on their own, some girls want a sweet chalk and Romeo. But around here, baby, I've learned you get what you can get. And if you're up and ready for love, honey, I'm tougher than the rest. The road is dark and it's a thin, thin line, but I want you to know I'll walk it for you any time. No other girlfriends, they couldn't pass this test. And if you're up and ready for love, honey, I'm tougher than the rest.
Thank you.